Don't give them what you promised them. What do you, as a cleaning or restoration company, what do you promise your customers? The very best, right? Well, I will do the very best I can. You're going to get the best. Everything I have to offer is going to be perfect. That's kind of how I view purchasing almost anything out there, like a cheeseburger, something as simple as going through the drive-thru. The reason why I talk about this and I like this graphic is because I went through a Steak and Shake one time and I saw a picture of, I think it was called like a Frisco Melt. I think that's what it was called. It was a nice burger with melted cheese and it was on a toasted bread. It was like, that picture was fantastic. And then I go through the drive-thru and I get my sandwich and I open it up and guess what I saw? I had to drive back around, look at that picture again, and then go, what is going on? It wasn't the same thing. Not quite. The lettuce was wilty. The bread was like smooshed over where the dressing was like sliding around. And you kind of had to push it all together, and then it was all over your fingers. Not the experience that was promised through the drive-thru. Do you see it from time to time yourself? When you hire a company, when you buy anything, when you... I mean, the Taco Bell commercial, that looks like the best Mexican food in the world. Maybe it is pretty tasty, but the look of it when you get it is not exactly what you see in the advertisement. So when you're going to promise something, you need to really deliver, even if you're in a hurry and you've got another job to do in a Friday afternoon at 4, give them what you promised them. Lots of surveys on what makes people happy about their purchase. We think, well, I'm the best carpet cleaner, I'm the best tech, water tech, I can do the best work, it's going to be squeaky clean when I'm done. That may be true, but that may not be exactly the big picture of what your customers are looking for. As you can see in this survey, this is a years old, of course, nothing new really, but numbers stay, because people are people. In this survey, 65% of those surveyed went somewhere else because they didn't like how they were treated. Here's what I want you to think about, a little test. Do you have any customers with you a while that trust you, that they're good customers, you take care of them, but what if you went the next time to their home and instead of actually cleaning, you vacuumed the carpet and they're not watching, you put some nice deodorizer down, you know, maybe some citrus or some vanilla, some nice vanilla deodorizer. You just kind of put it around the house a little bit. And you rake the carpet, so it looks like you cleaned the carpet, but you never actually cleaned it. And a carpet cleaner can tell you didn't really do the work. How many of you have a customer that would probably say, good job, and still pay you, and be kind of happy? Yeah, I see heads going, yeah. We have them, because they trust you. They like how you treat them. I had a technician working for me years ago that, his name was Jerry, he's no longer cleaning, but he went on some jobs with my truck, and he treated people really good. People loved him. I had a phone call from one customer that said, she called and said, you know, Jeff, some spots came back where Jerry had cleaned, and they're just kind of, you know, where I can really see them. They're in the middle of the room. I said, no problem, because what would you do, right? You go back and remove the spots. No trouble. I said, well, we'll have him come back, and how about Friday afternoon? He'll stop in and take care of those. She said, oh, no. I don't want to upset Jerry. Yeah, this really happened. She said, could you come out and do it? Now, why did she say that? She liked him so much. She did not want to have him think he failed her. That's how good he was with people. He was the absolute worst carpet cleaner in the world. This is going back a few years. You might remember Steamway 101, the spotter. He actually would run that through the rinse until I caught him. Because it cleaned spots so good, it must clean the carpet really good too. Yeah, so nothing exploded, truck still worked, but absolute worst cleaner in the world, but he had people skills you couldn't believe, and so when he would do a bad job, my customers would be like, they want to stick with us because of Jerry. Yeah. So you've got people like that too, that they dislike you because you're doing what? Treating them right. They like how they're treated. So it's not about the price, it's not even about not being totally happy with what you're doing, it's about being treated. This is not every single person, 65% said this, but it's enough of a motivator for you to rethink maybe how your employees are treating people and what can they do to be better. Do they need more time? Do they need a script? What do they need so the customers are like, I chose the right company? You know, you feel good about that when you do that? When you choose the best restaurant, the best service in your home, you feel proud of yourself. You found a good place. It's because you did your research. This is kind of what happens, though. People expect to be disappointed. When you think about buying a product or a service, in today's world, there's an expectation of, I'm not going to really get what was promised to me. Here's one big one on how to lose a customer, thinking about these promises. Don't we promise to answer our phone? Especially in restoration. We say 24/7, well, you call us, we'll answer, we'll be right there for you. Well, I tell you what, right back to you doesn't mean tomorrow, next week, or next month. It means I'm going to call you right back. When they call you and leave a message, what do they expect to happen if they have to leave that message? Yeah, they're going to put their phone down, and they know, because you promise emergency services, you're going to be right there calling them back. I remember one restoration company I called for another reason, but it was a 24/7, called, left a message, next day, called, left a message, and it's like they never answered their phone. They were screening their calls, who knows what, but they didn't actually answer the phone. That's a big deal. That's one big way to lose a customer, with bad phone skills. You think about these promises we're making. What do these two companies promise when they advertise? The guy on the left, he says he's gonna clean carpet. 5 rooms for $85. The guy on the right, he's gonna clean carpet. Who knows what the price is? We don't know. What are they promising?
Oh, the same thing.
The same thing. They're promising the exact same thing. And that's what your customers expect. When you make promises, they expect that every company is going to provide a certain baseline service. When they call you and say, can you come clean my carpet? They're not thinking, will it be all the way clean or halfway clean? They're not thinking that. They're thinking all of these companies out here are going to clean, to get it clean, just like when you go through a car wash, it's going to be a clean car when you come out the other end, but it's about the experience of cleaning. When you clean for them and they're happy with how they were treated, it doesn't matter too much on the technical skill as much as how they feel.